I'm Wizro 100. You're the viewers, and I'm the reviewer. I did not screw that up. Fuck you, Unreal. Hey, everybody! Welcome to the follow-up episode on the e-reader. And this time, we're gonna go take a look at Mario Party E and see if it's worth it. I'm Wizro 100. You're the viewers, and I'm the reviewer. So let's get it on. Last time, we took a look at the Nintendo e-reader, which had a lot of cool things going for it. If you haven't seen the video yet, go check out the video right now to catch up on what's going on. Okay, we ready to check this out? Alrighty then! Mario Party is a card game as stated on the box. It comes with 64 cards to play with, one playing mat to, well, play on, and an enclosed instruction manual, or booklet if you like pork cutlet. This game can be played with a boring two-player game up to an exciting four-player game, or more if you can get more, which is how you should play this game, as playing two players, you might as well just flip a coin and end with that. If you play with less than four players, you have to go through the trouble of taking out certain cards in order to make it more playable, I guess? Just don't play this game without four people, okay? Getting on to how to play this game, the goal of it is to collect three superstar item cards and playing the superstar card when you have all three, which basically means trying to summon Exodia with one less card. But before we get ahead of ourselves, let's set up the playing field. Well, first off, lay out the playing mat, and if you don't have it, just remember the layout. You have four sections on the mat where everyone has an in-play area of their own where you play your coin or item cards. In the middle of that, there's the deck area to put the remaining cards for players to draw, and a discard pile next to it where after using any cards, gets placed face up here. Alright, let's begin with what the rules are. First off, shuffle the cards like in any given card game, give each player 5 cards, which are known as hand cards, because they're cards in your hand! Get it? Oh Nintendo, you think you're so clever with that, aren't you? Oh yeah, and make sure you are the only one that can see your own cards, and at all times have 5 cards in your hand, before and after your turn. Now with the rest of the cards, put them face down in the deck pile where players will draw the cards each turn to see if they get lucky with anything. Now before the game begins, the youngest player goes first. Because you know, Nintendo is a family, kid-friendly game company, so of course the kids go first. And then the game goes clockwise from left to right from the player. Why not just say to the player's right or something? Don't complicate a simple process like whose turn it is next, and why can't the youngest just choose which way the game goes? Jeez, Nintendo, don't think about that idea. Brought to you by Nintendo, because durr. Now during every turn, each player draws one card from the deck. The player can either choose to play a card in their hand if possible, or discard any card that they can't play any. And if you somehow ended up with less or more than 5 cards before and after your turn, then something is wrong. After you're done with your turn, it's the next player's turn. The game keeps going until someone plays a superstar card that meets the winning requirements.
But it's not over yet! We still have to talk about the card types!
There are the coin cards that are essential to accomplishing anything from playing, or in this case, paying for item cards to be placed on the in-play area, or to use their effects. There is also the 2-coin promotional card from GamePro Magazine that you can use in the game that acts as 2 coins, which is kind of cool that you can alter the game slightly. Next are the item cards, which are key to winning the game, which contains Mario's hat, clothes, and shoes. You need to pay 2 coins for each of these, and you need all 3 of them to be able to win the game with the Superstar card. Speaking of the Superstar card, that card is very important to winning the game once you have all 3 Superstar items in your in-play area. But it can also be used to steal an in-play item card from an opponent, thus bringing you closer to victory. Just to be clear, you can only win with the Superstar card if you have all 3 item cards in play, and then you play this card to win. Otherwise, you just steal other players' item cards.
Oh, but surely there's a way to prevent other players from taking your cards, right? Lucky for you, in fact, there are cards that you can actually use to block players from taking your cards, called blocker cards. How appropriately named!
Basically, when another player attempts to steal your in-play cards or your hand cards with a card effect, You can use a blocker card to prevent that, granted that you are also able to pay one coin card for it, otherwise you can't do anything with it. Now, within three of the five blocker cards, there's an additional cost you can pay that's called a counter move that lets you steal other players' cards in return, depending on which card it is. There's a lot about the blocker cards that you need to be aware of. One, you can also block other blocker cards from blocking you. For some reason, this situation sounds funny to me, like you're blocking someone else's block, if you know what I mean. Two, a blocker card only works if a target is specifically you. On the back of the manual, it tells you that if there is an area effect card that takes items from everyone, you can't block it. 3. After using a blocker card, regardless of the situation it was used in, you must draw a card to maintain the number of cards you had before playing the blocker card. 4. You can also block dual cards since they're technically trying to take your cards.
Did you get all that? Because I had writer's block when I was writing that. So, I pay one coin to block that, and another coin to continue writing without having to search for my thoughts.
On the subject of searching, there are also search cards that allow you to take cards from the deck or the discard pile and exchange it with a card in your hand. Most of them require in-play coins to use except the Lakitu card. You're only allowed to search one pile if given the choice to search either, and it must be declared.
If this is getting too chaotic for your mind to handle, then don't worry! That's why there's the Chaos Cards!
The Chaos Cards, which is basically the screw other people's card, lets you take or exchange in-play or hand cards of other players. Now, most of them don't require coins to be played, making it easier to screw with other players or yourself over. Save for the Yoshi card, which still requires coins, but can be avoided by playing the e-reader minigames.
We'll get to the e-reader soon, but first, it's time to duel.
Last but not least are the duel cards, where you challenge other players for their cards by playing a minigame with the e-reader. Although, if you don't have the e-reader, you can settle it the boring way with a coin flip. Well, I'd flip that too if I didn't have an e-reader. Speaking of coins, some of the duel cards do require coins to be played, so be absolutely sure that you're going to win, or else you'll waste coins you could have used for something else. Okay, we got all that? How to set up the game, what the rules and goals are, what the cards do? Well then, now we're getting to the more e-citing part of Mario Party E. The e-reader minigames! Now, it must be clear from the start, if you use an e-reader, you must keep using it until the game ends. This means nobody can avoid playing the minigames. Now, in total, there are 11 e-reader challenge cards that can be played and for the most part are pretty fun to play. But before that, we've got to talk about the different types of challenge cards.
Thankfully, with only 11 cards, there's only 3 types of challenge cards.
First one is the free challenge cards. Most of the challenge cards in general involve the effects of stealing other players' cards. But the free challenge card, if you don't have the in-play coins to play the effect, you can declare free challenge and attempt to win the coins in the minigame to use the effect. If you lose the game, you just discard the card and nothing happens. The minigames in the free challenge are Cast Away Mario, where Mario must catch the right fish that Princess Peach wants. Cast Away Mario is pretty simple, short-lived, and not that challenging at all. It's not bad, just not that good. Mario's Mallet, where Mario must hammer slam all of the Goombas before they get Princess Peach. But be careful of hitting Luigi!
As much as I want to smash his head open for NES Remix 2. Oh, Luigi, you bastard!
This minigame is pretty frustrating, or at least to me, as I always accidentally bash Luigi's brain in, even when I had all the time in the world to check if it's him or a Goomba popping up. The number of Goombas you have to hammer is determined by what number you get in the beginning, but actually, for a Mario Party minigame, it's fitting. Simple, but tricky to master. Next is Daisy's Rodeo.
Oh my, that bullet bill sure likes the way it's being blown by Daisy. Now that's a blowjob.
Anyways, Daisy's Rodeo isn't Daisy being the town bicycle, but a game where you try to help Daisy hang on as long as possible to Bowser as he vibrates, I mean shake her all about, and do the hokey pokey, and that's what it's all about. Phew, managed to save that one, you know what I mean?
I mean, what kind of sexual anomaly is this supposed to be?
It's a quick time event game where you press the right buttons to hang on. It's very appropriate for a Mario Party game as it's something you would expect to see in one. Last one is Fast Feed Yoshi, which is basically just a roulette where you try to grab 2 coins within 3 tries. Yeah, that's it. It has a place in a Mario Party game, but that's pretty much the game if you can even call it one. The next type of challenge cards are Lakitu's Luck and Spinister Bowser. What's that supposed to mean? The Sinister Spinacher? Yeah, try saying that 3 times fast. Well anyways, both of these minigames are roulette games as well, with Lakitu's Luck benefiting the player using it mostly. And watch out for that cheap son of a bee for changing the outcome at the end.
You son of a bitch!
And Spinister Bowser, oh god, that name's dumb, but I get it, where the outcome involves hopefully screwing everyone as well and not just you. Again, just like the Fast Feet Yoshi game, it has a place in a Mario Party game, except these two are a lot more interesting to play with. The last challenge card types are the duel cards, which are also the more interesting minigames as you choose which player you want to duel with. It also has a practice mode to get yourself familiar with the game, but the controls are pretty simple, as are the rest of the minigames. First is Bolt from Boo, where you try to get Mario to the door as fast as possible without getting caught by Boo. You move by mashing the A and B button as quickly as you can and let go of it at the right time for Mario to turn around to stop Boo. The one who makes it to the door the fastest wins the game. I quite like this game, although I can never get sub 5 seconds on this. Except during recording I did get sub 5 seconds. Barely though, but regardless, this minigame is pretty fun to try and get the fastest time. I hope I'm not running out of time because it's Waluigi's Time Bomb Ticks, where the first player tries to set up the bomb as quickly and as accurately as possible by pressing the numbers from 1 to 16 to give the second player less time to disarm it. Player 2 then attempts to disarm the bomb as quickly and as accurately as they can to win the game.
Oh, I guess player 1 is a terrorist!
This is a pretty interesting minigame that determines the difficulty of the game based on the player's speed and accuracy. As usual, this is fitting for a Mario Party versus game, and the game over screen is sort of overdramatic. Another Waluigi duel card is Waluigi's Reign, where the goal is Mario comes in trying to steal coins without getting hit by hammers. A pretty fun minigame to play and with some catchy music. The last two duel games are Wario's Bluff and Balloon Burst. Wario's Bluff is basically playing chicken as you try to get to the edge as close as possible without falling off. It's kind of like Bolt from Boo, but it's not a bad minigame. In fact, it's pretty fun to play, although you could cheat in this game and slowly get to the edge as close as possible, even with the time limit. Balloon Burst is where you and your opponents take turn pumping a balloon of Wario and whoever pops it first loses. This game reminds me of the minigame in Yoshi's Island with the balloon, which is actually a little more interesting to play. And I also found out that player 1 has a huge advantage in this game as he can just make the balloon as big as he wants on the first turn without any consequences, and player 2 gets to eat a game over screen 80% of the time. Overall, the minigames can be fun and they do add to the card game.
Now that I've talked about the minigames and the card games, what do I think of it?
I had quite a lot of fun playing this game with the guys, and with the card game, to me, there's almost like a psychological battle between players, kind of like poker. Like who has what cards, predicting what moves they may or may not be intending to do, or how to foil the other player's plans. Because there were a lot of tense moments where I wasn't sure if Ninja Raptor or SCXCR were going to win when they had full item cards in play. You can see our entire playthrough of the game in wonderful low lighting conditions, which I would have liked to change. The minigames, like I said, can be fun and they do add to the Mario Party experience. I also got the guys' opinions on the game, so let's see what they think of the game.
It's a game. 7 out of 10. I'm too adverse with board games to really comment on it.
Would never play again.
Wasn't too complex, I could say that. I don't know, they kind of feel more in between like actual Mario Party games and more like WarioWare games.
I don't really like party games. I didn't really like most of the mini games in Mario Party.
I think there was like less shorter and less complex than some Mario Party games, which again aren't really that complex, but a few of them took more time than like a WarioWare game would, so I guess. And I did have some fun until I got screwed over at the end. I ended up with 4 coin cards at once.
The most fun I had the entire game was gathering up a hand with 4 coins in it and passing it off to that guy over there.
I don't see it, but I see everything in the middle finger. He's part of get to Ninja Raptor. Probably the most fun is screwing the other players over, you would say.
And there's plenty of opportunities to do that. I mean, but with all the different cards that you can trade hands with and such.
It's a good way to kill time, you know, go ahead, you want, try it, you know.
Actually, yeah, why not?
It's not like a thing you have to do before you die or anything like that, but, yeah. I'm being so specific and informative here, aren't I?
Unfortunately, Blonde Guy Gamer was too tired to give an opinion, but I'd imagine it'd be in between Ninja's and SCXCR's opinions.
So, is this card game worth it? Well, yeah, I think it's worth searching for because it's a fun game.
If you can find it for a good price, I would definitely say go for it, because I do recommend playing this game. This card game almost makes it worth getting an e-reader along with it, because the minigames do add to the Mario Party feel. Even if it gets a little annoying having to stop the game and scan the cards in, you'd think Nintendo would have made a cartridge port of this game included with the card game that you just pass around. Or they could have done something cool like make more minigame cards to scan into play. Wouldn't that be cool? It would make the game different each time with different minigames placed in. I mean, you had the promotional 2-coin card that you can use in the game, so why not?
Oh well, what's done is done. But yeah, I say that the Mario Party E card game is worth it. So, this is WizWar 100, you're the viewers and I'm the reviewer, so stay tuned for more!
Hey guys, thanks for watching and I hope you enjoyed it. And if you want more than you can see here, be sure to follow me on my Facebook and Twitter for updates on reviews and videos. If you want to help me out, I have a Patreon account, and if you haven't already done so, subscribe to my YouTube channel for more video game content for you to watch, such as the videos I'm showcasing right now. Check out my site LazyWorks Creations and River City Gamers for more content like mine, such as this video's recommendations is SCXCR's Apocalypse Review, where you might just see someone you know pop up. Links to all that goodness is right in the description, or click the annotations if you're watching on YouTube.
But it's not over yet! We still have to talk about the card types! What the hell was that?